As we explore the world of Google Analytics, we are going to encounter some terminologies that you may be unfamiliar with. I'll do my best to explain these terms as we encounter them, but I want to give you one point of reference in this course, so you can quickly review these from time to time. First up is attribution, and this is the process of assigning credit for sales and conversions to touch points in those conversion paths. Essentially, you are quantifying a contribution a particular channel made on your sales or conversions. Along with attribution, we have the attribution model. And this is a rule or set of rules that determines how credit for sales or conversions are assigned to each touch point in a user's journey. There are different types of models, say last click attribution or first click attribution. Last click attribution would assign 100% credit to the final touch point before the user purchased. Say a user went to Google, looked for your site, found a blog, clicked on the blog, read another article, and then clicked on a link to your site. There were many steps in that path, and with last click attribution, 100% of the credit goes to that final click. Whereas first click attribution assigns 100% of the credit to the touch point that started that conversion path, so that searched or Google would get all the credit when they click onto your site. We are going to go deeper into that in our later chapter. From here, let's take a look at a conversion. This is a completed activity, online or offline, that is important to the success of your business. You might measure a conversion once someone signs up to your email newsletter, which would be a goal conversion, or makes some purchase on your site, say an e-commerce conversion. As you start to interact data on Google Analytics, you'll come across some definitions specific to how Google organizes your data. And the first is dimension. This is a descriptive attribute or characteristic of data. Browser, landing page, and campaign are all examples of default dimensions in the Google Analytics. Now, another example would be a geographic location having dimensions such as city names or state. You also have browser, exit page, screens, and sessions, which are all other examples of dimensions that are going to appear by default in Google Analytics. Now, Google's also going to give you the opportunity to track an event. And this is a type of hit used to track user interactions with your content. You might track downloads, mobile, and clicks when someone plays a video or, say, downloads a PDF. From there, you might set up a goal, and this is a configuration settings that allows you to track the valuable actions happening on your site. Goals allow you to measure how well you are fulfilling your business objectives. You can set up individual goals to track discrete actions like getting people to visit at least 5 pages of your site. Or someone who spends at least a certain amount of money on your products. Every time a user completes a goal, a conversion is logged into your Google Analytics account. So, think of a goal as potentially a series of actions that must occur for you to consider a conversion event. Now, you have heard me from time to time to refer to what's known as a hit. And this is an interaction that results in data being sent to Google Analytics. Common hit types include page tracking, event tracking, and e-commerce tracking. Each time the tracking code is triggered by a user, that data is packaged into a hit and sent to Google servers. As you look deeper at this data, you interact with what's known as a metric. This is a quantitative measurement of your data. Metrics in Google Analytics can either be sum or ratios. For example, the metric of the city dimension is going to be how many residents it has, screen views, pages per session, and average session duration are other examples of metrics you'll find in Google Analytics. You'll also be spending a lot of time reviewing your page views. A page view is different from visitors. This is an instance of a page being loaded or reloaded in a browser. Page view is a metric to find as a total number of pages viewed. One unique user can contribute multiple page views. Once we start playing with reports, you'll encounter what's known as segment. This is basically a subset of sessions or users that share common attributes. Segments allow you to isolate and analyze groups of sessions or users for better analysis. You might segment your data by marketing channel so you can see which channel is responsible for increase in purchases, or you might segment your data by geographic region to see what parts of the country or the world are improving your performance. Coming down to looking at segments of your data helps you understand what causes a change to all of that aggregate data. Now, if you're curious how Google understands how many page views a unique user provides, it's all about the session. A session is a period of time a user is active on your site. By default, if a user is active for 30 minutes or more, any future activity is attributed to a new session, meaning there's a repeat visitor. Users that leave your site and return within 30 minutes are counted as part of the original session. Another one that you'll see all over the place, and we are going to spend a great bit of time interacting with, is source and medium. Source is the origin of your traffic, such as a search engine. For example, Google or a particular domain name, such as mysite.com. The medium is a general category of the source. For example, it could be an organic search in the case of Google. It could be social in the case of Facebook. It could be a click search or even a referral from another website. The course or medium, which you'll see together quite frequently, is a dimension that combines the two. Now, we'll encounter more terminologies on the way, but these are the core concepts you'll want to be familiar with to get the most out of this course. That's all for this video, and stay subscribed for more videos. Thank you.